see the 1.2 seventh problem. Okay, 1.2 already we have completed up to 5 problems. So now sixth problem. So in a test, 3 marks are given for every correct answer. Okay, now. And -1 marks are given for every incorrect answer. So one test was kept by the teacher. So each question carries 3 marks. Incorrect question carries -1 mark. Sonu attempted all the questions and scored 20 marks. Through she got 10 correct answers. So Sonu attempted all the questions in that exam. So she got the marks 20 marks. In the 20 marks, she was corrected 10 correct answers. Okay, now 10 correct answers means each correct answer she will get 3 marks. So 10 into 3, 30 marks. Okay, now 30 marks. So we can see the answer. So first question, how many incorrect answers she attempted? So incorrect answers, how many are there? Next, how many questions were given in the test? So totally how many questions? So the question is, each question carries correct answer 3 marks, incorrect answer -1 mark. So she attempted all the questions, she got the 20 marks. So each for that test she got 10 correct answers. Okay, now 10 correct answers. So first question is, how many incorrect questions she attempted? Second question is, how many questions were given in the test? Let us see. 10 correct answers means 10 correct answers. 10 correct answers into each correct answers they will give 3 marks. So 3, that equal to 30 marks. She will get 30 marks. Okay. But she got only 20 marks. But she got only 20 marks means here you want to subtract with 10. Why you are subtracting with 10 means you 10 questions will be incorrect answers. Okay, now our assumption. So 10 incorrect. Okay, now let us assume 10 incorrect answers into -1. So it will become -10 marks. So what is the total? So 30 minus 10, 20. So that is 20 marks. Okay, that is 20 marks. So that is 20 marks. So 10 correct answers, each question carries 3 marks. So she will get 30 marks. So 10 incorrect answers she attempted, so -1. So that equal to -10 marks. So by doing the subtraction, but the total 20 marks. So let us see. Sonu attempted all the questions. Okay, now she attempted all the questions and scored 20 marks. See, 20 marks she got. True, she got 10 correct answers. See here, 10 correct answers she attempted, she got 30 marks. By incorrect answers, 10. By substituting -10, she will get 20 marks. Okay, 20 marks. So correct answers is 10 marks. Incorrect questions is 10 questions. So correct questions also 10 questions. So what is the first question? How many incorrect answers she attempted? Incorrect answers means 10. How many incorrect answers she attempted means 10 incorrect answers. First question. So second question, how many questions were given in the test? So totally how many questions means 10 correct, 10 incorrect means totally how many questions? 20 questions they given for the test. So 20 questions they given, 10 incorrect answers, 10 correct answers. Okay, so that is the answers. First question is 10 incorrect answers she attempted. Second one answer is total test is 20 questions they given for the test. Let us see the next one. Next question. See the next question. Seventh one. Write 5 pairs of integers. Okay, now write 5 pairs of integers. That is a comma b such that a divided by b equal to minus 4. So you want to write down 4 pairs. 4 or 5? So sorry, 5 pairs you want to write down. So let us see. So what is the problem? A divided by B is equal to minus 4. You want to get A divided by B equal to minus 4. So that is the problem. So they given for you one example also. One example also they given. What is the example? 12 divided by minus 3. So that equal to 12 divided by minus 3. So by doing the division, so you will get minus 4. Let us see. 12 divided by minus 3. 12 divided by minus 3. So minus is there. So in denominator it will come to numerator also. So it will become minus 3 ones, 3 fours. So what is the value? Minus 4. So what is the value? Minus 4. Minus 4. So these two are integers. Okay. Write 5 pair of integers. Okay, now these two are integers. So you want to write down in the pair. Okay, now pair variable. 12 comma minus. So that is the pair. Next example. So 40. Minus 40 divided by 10. Minus 40 divided by 10. So it will become 10 ones, 10 fours. So minus is there. So minus 4. So what is the pair? Minus 40 comma 10. Okay, now minus 40 comma 10. So let us take another example. Okay, now as you wish. So 20 divided by minus 5. 20 divided by minus 5. So minus is there. So minus 5 ones, 5 fours. So it will become. So what is the pair? 20 comma minus 5. So this is also one pair. So another example. So minus 80 divided by, so you want to get the 4. So 20. Okay, minus 80 divided by 20. So it will become minus 4. So you want to write down in the pair. So that is minus 80 comma 20. So that is the 4 only. So let it be. Write down one example. Another example. So 200. Okay, now 200 only. 28 divided by minus 7. Okay, now. So minus is there. So by coming to numerator also, it will become minus only. So 7 ones, 7 fourths. So what is the value? Minus 4. So write down in the pair. 28 comma minus 7. So as always, you can take any example. Okay, now. So that is my example 5. You can take any example. So this is the 7 questions in the 1.2 exercise. So So let us see the next exercise. Before seeing the exercise, we will see the belongs to symbol. Okay. Some introduction part is there. Let us see. So this is the belongs. Okay, now this is the belongs symbol. So this is not belongs. This is not belongs. Meaning what? Okay, ये देना ओके नंबर. Okay, now let us see. Zero belongs to W. So that means what is the meaning of W? Whole number. So in whole number zero is there. So we can call it as 0 belongs to W. So 4 belongs to W. Next, minus 5 belongs to W. So let us see. In whole number, only positive numbers and also 0. So 4 is positive numbers. So it belongs to W. So minus 5 is not in whole number, because whole numbers means positive numbers and 0. So this is negative number. So minus 5 belongs to whole number? No, it is not belongs. So you can write it as like that. So minus 5 does not belongs to W. Ante minus 5 anedi whole numbers lo ledu ani dan meaning. Okay, minus 5 anedi whole numbers lo ledu. So what the symbol? Does not belongs. Understood? Let us see. Zero belongs to n. So zero belongs to n. So n means natural number. In natural number, zero is there? No. So that is does not belongs. So zero does not belongs to n. Okay, no. Zero does not belongs to n. So minus 5 belongs to I. Minus 5 belongs to I. I means integers. Integers means positive numbers, negative numbers and also 0. So this is negative number. Negative numbers are in the integers. So it belongs. So minus 5 belongs to I. Okay, no, I or Z. So integers symbol is I or Z. Okay, no. So minus 5 belongs to I. Minus 5 belongs to I. So that is the examples of belongs and not belongs. So for given any element, it belongs to the given element or not, you want to see another. Okay, let us see another topic. So next topic is properties of integers. Okay, now what is the next topic? Properties of integers. So next topic is properties of integers. So that is 1.3. Okay, now 1.3 properties of integers. Let us see. So what is the properties of integers? So we have closure property. We have the closure property. Next, commutative property. Let us see. Closure property. Okay, now or we can call closure law. Next, commutative. Commutative law. Next, associative law. associative law. Next, distribution. Distribution. Distributive law. Okay. These are the properties of integers. So that is closure property, commutative properties, sorry, loss, associative law, distribution law. So what is the closure property? Closure property ante ela untundo chuddam. So in closure property, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division also is there. Okay. Na? So addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Okay. Na? So in this also commutative also addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. In this associative law also addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So in this distribution law also addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So let us see first of all closure property. So what is meant by closure property? So closure property lo identity, sorry, integers. Okay, in closure property, what is the under, what is the under closure property law in addition and also subtraction and multiplication division? Let us see. So closure law, closure law, closure law, addition, in subtraction, multiplication, so division. Let us see. So A plus B, again A plus B belongs to Z. So what is the meaning of Z? Z means integer. Z and integer and I have to like I. So that is the symbol of integer. I or Z. Okay. A plus B belongs to I. Okay. Now, A and B are integer. Addition is a, okay. Now, addition is a, manaki I integer like out on the level choose quality. Let us see. So that is the loss. Take one example, A, B. Okay, any one. So here A, B are integers. Okay, A and B are integers. So I will take one example, 4. 4 plus 5 equal to 9. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Okay. So let us see, 4 is integer and 5 also integer. So what is the value? That is 9. So 9 also integer. So A plus B belongs to I, we can call. So here also see, 5 plus 4, this is also integer, this is also integer. So it will become 9. So 9 also integer. So edaina two numbers ni add chese aa vache value kuda answer, okay na, ikkada vachina answer kuda integer e raavali appude dani belongs ani cheppagalam. Okay na, it will be belongs, a plus b belongs to I in addition ani cheppagalam. Okay na, values kani ikkada integers raakokunda variables ostey kada, it does not belongs. Okay na, it does not belongs in addition. Okay na, let us see. Minus 5 plus 4, it will become minus 1. So 4 plus minus 5, so what is the value? 4 plus in the brackets minus 5, plus into minus minus. So 5 minus 4 means 1. Big value having minus, big value having minus. So let us see. Same problem. 5 plus minus 4. Again, 5 plus minus 4. So 5 having positive, 4 having negative. So plus into minus minus. 5 minus 4, 1. big value having positive, so plus 1. Let us see. These two are integers. These two also integers. So what is the value? Answer also integer. Okay, answer also integer. So these two are integers. Answer also integer. So on yenta additions lo, okay, na positive iskuna, negative iskuna, yen iskuna kuda answer sanni ela vachadi integers lo vachay kaabatti. So a plus b belongs to I and cheppachu. Okay, a plus b belongs to I. So it is correct. So it is correct. It belongs. Integers are okay na, and integer is okay na, r anabodu ikkada only addition iskuntaru kada, integer is under addition of closure law. Okay na, closure law like that we can call. Next is the subtraction. A minus b, okay na, a minus b. So let us take one example. 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. Okay. So these two are integers. So answer also integer. These two are integers. Answer also integer. So it is belongs to subtraction also integers. So మనం ఇక్కడ ఈ రెండు వాల్యూస్ ని సబ్ట్రాక్షన్ చేసి ఆన్సర్ కూడా ఎలా వచ్చిందంటే ఇంటీజర్ లోనే వచ్చింది కదా. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ కరెక్ట్. సో ఏ మైనస్ బి బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఐ. ఏ మైనస్ బి బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఐ. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో ఇన్ ద క్లోజర్ లా ఆఫ్ సబ్ట్రాక్షన్. నెక్స్ట్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ యూ విల్ సీ. ఏ ఇంటూ బి, ఓకేనా, ఏ ఇంటూ బి. సో లెట్ అస్ సీ. 5 into 4 that equal to 20. 4 into 5 that equal to 20. Minus 4 into 5 so that equal to minus 20. 4 into minus 5 so that equal to minus 20. So let us see. 5 into 4, these two are integers. Answer also integer. So all answers also integers only. So A into B belongs to I kada. Answers are ikkada integers lo vachayi. So we can call it as A into B belongs to I. Belongs to I. Belongs to I. Let us see the division. Let us see the division. So A divided by B. Okay, now A divided by B. So let us say, take one example. So this is next division. Next division. Okay. So there is no place. That's why I have written to the left side of us. Let us see. Division. A divided by B. So let us take 5 divided by 4. So 5 divided by 4 means, so that equal to 5 by 4. So we can do the cancellation. 4 ones. Okay. 4 ones are 4. 4 ones are 4. So what is the remainder? Remainder will be 1. can remainder will be 1. So it will not be cancelled. So you want to put the point. So it will become 10. Okay, it will become 10. So 4. How many times it will go? 2 times. So 4 2s. 4 2s. Okay, now. So what the remainder? 4 2s are 8. 2 will be the remainder. So point is there, no? That's why you will put the in the dividend 0. So it will become 20. So 4 5s. So 4 5s. So what is the answer? 1.25. So ikkada em ante meaning 4 divided by 5 4 to 5 ni division chesthe perfect ga divisible kaaledandi ikkada perfect ga divisible kaaledu adi ela vastundante decimals lo vastundi value okay na it will become in decimals so a divided by b belongs to I manaku decimals lo raagudu kada integers lo ne answer raavali okay na manaki ela raavali answers mottham integers lo raavali I mean positive number, negative number or zero. Okay, now ikkada manaki ela vachindandi decimals lo vachindi. So it does not belongs to I. A divided by B does not belongs to I am cheppagalam. Okay, it does not belongs because manaki answer integers lo ne raavali. Akkada answer integers lo raaledu. Ela vachindandi decimal lo vachindi. So that's why it does not belongs to integers in division. Okay, in division. In division. So in closure law, addition is an integer, subtraction is an integer, multiplication is an integer, so division is not in integer. So integers are closure law. Integers are closure law under addition, subtraction, multiplication. Okay, only multiplication. So integers are closer under law addition, subtraction, multiplication. Okay, na integers anedi closer law lo addition, subtraction, multiplication lo maatrame undi, division lo ledandi. Okay, division lo led akkada. So that is the closure law. Next class we will see the commutative, associative, distribution laws. Okay.